So now we have to discuss how we can go for a good cost revision. What are the alternatives we can use in place of the old course material?
Well, why don't we make a list of latest textbooks in the subject area and obtain access to the instructor manuals and the PowerPoint slides?
Yes, that is something. But unfortunately, all books don't have instructor manual and PowerPoints. You know, most of time it is not allowed even photocopy the relevant part of a book to distribute among students.
Yes, that's the point. And the other problem is, most of the time, such textbooks are expensive. And we are currently facing some financial issues purchasing of course material.
Can't we take the relevant content, including diagrams and notes, and alter them to match our requirements?
I don't think that's a good idea. We face copyright violation issues just for copying the information from the existing material. So altering them would be out of the question.
Yes, that's a problem.
Don't we have any open source material that we can use, just like open source software?
There are something called Open Educational Resources, OER, that we can use.
What are open educational resources?
Well, just like open source software, they are freely available for the users.
Great! Can we make changes and alter them according to our requirements?
They have some sort of a licensing method which we must follow. And according to the type of the material, we can change or alter them to suit our needs.
Are there only text-based material?
There are text-based ones, as well as audio visuals and other formats.
Interesting. How exactly can we use this OER?
Well, actually I got introduced to them recently, so I am not familiar with the use of OER.
Okay. This is interesting. Let's all find out more about OER and explore its potential when we meet in a week's time for a discussion on whether we can practically use this OER for our work.